Hello everyone, welcome to the economics class. And as you all know, we have been discussing about government budget in our previous class. So we will continue with the topic, that is government budget. And let me introduce myself. I am Virat Chetri, PhD economics in Kendriya Vidyalaya Badhui. And in this chapter we have been discussing about few things, and we have already discussed about meaning and objectives of government budget, and then we discussed about components of budget, revenue and capital receipts. Today we are going to discuss about components of budget, revenue and capital expenditures, and then in our next classes we will be discussing about what budget deficit is and how is it calculated and all. So without making much delay, I would like to start with today's class. Okay, before starting today's class, let us recall few things from our previous class. As you all know, we have already discussed about the meaning of government budget, and we have also discussed about components of budget in our last class, isn't it? So in components of budget, we have learned about classifying the components of budget into two categories. One was in terms of affecting assets and liabilities of the government, and other one was in terms of income and expenditure of the government. And we have taken the second part, that is classifying the government budget or the components of government budget on the basis of income or the receipts and the expenditure of the government. And on that basis we have classified components of budget or budget into two categories, that is in terms of budget receipts and in terms of budget expenditure. And under budget receipts, we have already discussed in previous class that under budget receipts there are two parts, that is revenue receipts and capital receipts. And under capital receipts, under revenue receipts, there are two sources of revenue receipts, that is tax revenue and non-tax revenue. And under this capital receipts, we have discussed about various sources of capital receipts, that is borrowings, repayment of loans, and then we have also discussed about other receipts, isn't it, in our last class. So this portion which we are going to discuss today is a continuation of the last or the previous class. It is related to the last class, so you have to take the whole lecture, that is from part 1, part 2, and you have to relate it with this lecture which I am going to deliver today. Okay, now let us see what budget expenditure means. Okay, what does budget expenditure means? So budget expenditure refers to the estimated expenditure of the government. Since we all know that the budget does not give us the actual picture, it is actually the estimated expenditure and receipt of the government during a particular fiscal year. So what does budget expenditure means? Budget expenditure also means the estimated expenditure or estimated expenses of the government on different items during a given fiscal year. Okay, under different heads, how the government is going to spend the money, or how the government has planned to spend the money in the coming year or in the coming fiscal year, it is known as the budget expenditure. And budget expenditure can be further categorized into two parts. Okay, that is, as you can see, revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Just like revenue receipts and capital receipts in case of budget receipts, here in case of budget expenditure we will have two categories, that is revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Okay, we can see the classification as follows. Budget expenditure can be categorized into two parts, that is revenue expenditure and capital expenditure. Okay, now we will go into details about what revenue expenditure actually means. Okay, so let us see what revenue expenditure means. Revenue expenditure refers to that expenditure of government which will neither create any asset or nor will reduce any liabilities of the government. So revenue expenditure is such type of expenditure which will have no impact at all on the assets and liabilities of the government. If you can recall from previous class, then you should know that in case of revenue receipts also, revenue receipts were those receipts of the government which were not impacting either the asset or the liabilities of the government. So here also we see that revenue expenditure are such type of expenditures of the government which will neither affect the liability nor affect the asset of the government. Okay, so it is also recurring in nature. Recurring in nature means it will keep on occurring. If the government will keep on spending money under this head, that is revenue expenditure. And as you can recall from previous class, revenue receipts were also recurring in nature, regular in nature. Okay, so what are the examples of revenue expenditure? If you can see the examples of revenue expenditure, then payment of salaries, okay, payment of salaries to the government employees, payment of pensions to the government employee, expenditure on administrative services, courts, health services, defense services, etc. Okay, as you can see, payment of salaries, pensions, etc. are regular in nature. Every month the government will have to pay the salaries of the government employee, pensions of the government, retired government employees. Okay, they will have to bear some expenses on the administrative services, maintaining law and order, courts, etc. Okay, so health services which the government provides, hospitals and all, education services, education facilities which the government provides, the expenditure on the education, providing education facilities. These are all examples of revenue expenditure. On the other hand, capital expenditure. In case of capital expenditure, what happens is those expenditure which will either create an asset or will reduce liability. We have to keep these two things in mind. Okay, will either create assets or reduce liabilities of the government. Okay, it will either create assets or reduce liabilities of the government. So there are two things. The expenditure which will either create asset, or on the other hand, if a particular expenditure of the government is going to reduce the liability of the government, then it is treated as capital expenditure. Let us see some of the examples of capital expenditure. Since this is not a regular phenomena, so it is also non-recurring in nature. It will not repeat again and again. It is once in a blue moon type of expenditure by the government. Government will really like to have a capital expenditure. Government obviously need to make revenue expenditure time and again, but capital expenditure, government try to avoid capital expenditures as much as possible. Okay, so it is non-recurring in nature. So what distinguishes it from revenue expenditure is that it is non-recurring in nature. Non-recurring means it is irregular. This type of expenditure is irregular, it is not a regular phenomenon. On the other hand, in case of revenue expenditure, we see that it is regular in nature. Okay, it is regular in nature, so every month the government have to make the payment, or the government have to bear that expenses. But in case of capital expenditure, it is not like that. Say once in a year, or once in 2 years, or once in 5 years, government will be bearing such type of expenditure. So what are the examples of capital expenditure? The examples of capital expenditure are loan to states. Okay, it is loan to states and union territory. UTs here means union territories, and expenditure on building roads. Like when the road is being built, or when there is expansion of railways, or when a bridge is being constructed, what happens is, though the government is spending the money, asset is being created. Okay, keep that in mind. It is either creation of asset, isn't it? It is either creation of asset or reduction in liabilities. So what happens here is, when a government is going to build a road, or construct flyovers, construct railways or expansion of railways, construct airports, construct dams, etc., it is definitely an asset for the government. Okay, so asset is being created, even though the government is spending money, but it is going to create an asset. Okay, on the other hand, loan given to states and unions, loan given to states and union territories is also regarded as an asset to the government, because until and unless those loans are being repaid by the states, it will keep on giving the interest rate to the government, to the union government, that is to the central government. So it will open up a possibility, or it will open up an opportunity to keep on earning at least interest money from the state. So it is treated as an asset in that sense, because the money is going to keep money is going to come regularly, okay, to the government. Okay, that is the central government. On the other hand, repayment of loans, if you can see, if the central government has taken some loans previously, it is a liability on the government. So government will have to not only repay back the principal amount, but also it has to keep on making the interest payments. So what happens here actually is, on repayment of loans, the liability which was there with the central government gets reduced. Burden is off the back of the government. Okay, so the government will be reducing its liabilities when it makes repayment of loans, when it pays back the loans. Okay, so it is the reason why it is an example of capital expenditure. Why is it an example of capital expenditure? It is an example of capital expenditure because once the government is repaying the loan, it is shedding off the burden of loans taken by the government. So as a result, obviously the liability of the government is reducing, and we have already seen that there are two criterias. Okay, there are two criterias. One is either creation of assets or reduction of liabilities of the government. So here it satisfies the second condition, that is, is going to reduce the liabilities of the government. Okay, now let us see the difference between revenue and capital expenditure. We have already discussed few of the differences between revenue and capital expenditure, so we will just go through it once again. And in this chapter, as you can see, or this unit, it is a very important unit as far as the board exam is concerned, because this unit, or this particular individual chapter, comprises of 6 marks in your board exam. Okay, and most probably there is a chance that you will be getting either 4 marks or 3 marks question, one question of either 4 marks or 3 marks, and rest, that is either 3 marks or 2 marks, you will be getting 1 marks question each. And there is a very less possibility of getting 6 marks question from this chapter. Okay, so these differences may come of 3 marks or 4 marks, so that is the reason why we are taking 4 differences instead of only 3 differences. Okay, and in case of revenue receipts and capital receipts also, we have taken 4 differences, and in case of direct and indirect taxes also, we have discussed about 4 differences. The main reason behind discussing 4 differences is that if you get the 4 marks question, then you have to write the 4 differences. So that is the reason why we are taking 4 differences each. Okay, so without discussing much about that, now let us focus on our topic. Okay, our topic is difference between revenue and capital expenditure. And revenue and capital expenditure, we have already discussed about it, isn't it? The definition: revenue expenditure is such type of expenditure of the government which will neither affect asset or nor affect liability. Okay. And the capital expenditure is such type of expenditure the government is spending, but this expenditure of government is increasing asset and reducing the liability of the government. Okay, you have to keep that in mind. And revenue expenditure, as we have already discussed, is regular in nature and recurring in nature. It occurs again and again, it repeats again and again. This type of expenditure is taken by the government again and again. Okay, on the other hand, capital expenditure is such type of expenditure which is not regular in nature. It is irregular and non-recurring in nature. It may, government may spend once in a year or say once in 2 years' time or once in 5 years' time, but revenue expenditure is quite regular every month. Right? The government is spending every month or every day, etc. Okay, so we have seen the similar differences in case of revenue receipt and capital receipt, which I have discussed in previous class. Okay, if you remember, then you will find the same difference over there also. A revenue receipt is such type of receipt which is not going to affect asset and liabilities of the government. On the other hand, capital receipts are those receipts which will affect asset and liability. It will affect asset in such a way that the government's asset will reduce and the government's liabilities will increase. Okay, so here it is just the opposite. In case of capital expenditure, the expenditure will either create asset or reduce the liability of the government. Okay, so revenue expenditure, where is government going to spend money here? It is for the normal functioning of the government, day-to-day functioning of the government, making payments to the different departments, giving salaries, etc. On the other hand, capital expenditure. Okay, capital expenditure is incurred mainly for increasing the asset of the government or reducing the liabilities of the government, or giving loans to or granting loans to the state governments, union territories, etc. Okay. And what are the examples of revenue expenditure? Examples of revenue expenditure, as we have already discussed, salaries, pensions, interest. You have seen that in case of revenue receipts also we have written interest as an example. Okay. So here, in that case, interest on the loans given by central government to the state government was included. Okay, that was the receipt, interest receipt of the government. Here, interest payment by the government is included. Interest payment means when the government is taking loan from either the abroad country, either from the institutions, international institution, or from some of the abroad countries, or from RBI itself, then the government will have to make two types of repayment. One is interest repayment on the loans taken. Another one is repayment of the principal amount itself. So here, whenever the interest payment or interest receipts comes under consideration, then it is part of revenue budget. Please keep this in mind very clearly, that interest payment made by the central government or the government to other institutions, foreign countries, etc., is included in revenue budget, that is revenue expenditure. And if the government is receiving interest on the loans given by central government to the state government, then that interest receipt becomes the part of revenue receipt. Revenue receipt is also component of revenue budget. So interest is always a part of revenue budget, but the principal amount of loan, the principal amount of loan, if that is repaid by the government, okay, so let's say the central government has taken some loan from RBI and now the central government is repaying it back to RBI, that is the principal amount is being repaid to the RBI, and that repayment of loans, that repayment of principal amount is now a part of capital budget. And since government is giving the money, so it is expenditure. Since government is spending money, so it is expenditure, capital expenditure. On the other hand, if the government gets back the repayment of loans from the state government, okay, the government, central government has given loan to the state government and the state government has is now repaying it back, the principal amount is being repaid by the state governments to the central government, then that means some income is coming to the central government, and that income which is coming to the central government because of the repayment of loans by the state government becomes the part of capital receipt. It will also be the part of capital budget, but since the money is coming to the government, it becomes part of capital receipt. And here, repayment of loans by the central government becomes part of capital expenditure. Similarly, construction of bridges, roads, etc., because it is going to create assets, so it is a part of capital expenditure. We have discussed this in previous slide also. So hope you have understood till here, isn't it? So we will move forward. Okay, here I have tried to give you a simple formula to differentiate between capital receipts and capital expenditures. Okay, capital receipts and expenditures. Here, expenditures means capital expenditure. You will see that in previous year's question paper. Okay, if you collect the previous year's question paper from CBSE's website, then you will see that quite often from this chapter you will get a question, okay, which will be of such a way that identify whether the following is a capital receipt or revenue receipt. Give reasons for your answer. On the other hand, you will also find the questions like identify from the following whether it is a capital expenditure or revenue expenditure and give reason for that. If you are not able to give reason, you will find say four statements are there and you have to classify it and give reasons also. And if you classify it properly, correctly, but you are unable to give proper reason, then you will not be getting any marks at all. Okay, if you download the answer key, okay, CBSE's answer key, you will clearly find it is written there that if the reason is incorrect, then you will not be getting any marks at all. Even if it is of say 3 statement comes and it is of 6 marks, say, then you will not be getting any marks, 0 marks, so not even half marks for each correct identification is also not given. So you have to be very aware and you have to be very concerned when you are going to write the answer. Okay, you may easily identify that okay, this is capital receipt, this is capital expenditure, but you may not be able to give reasons, you may get confused. Okay, so in order to do away with those confusion, I have created a formula for that. Okay, a simple formula. Okay, hope you will like it and it will help you to memorize this thing. Okay, let's see. There are two types of usually, because in case of revenue receipt and revenue expenditure, if you are able to identify that it is okay, the money is coming to the government, central government, then obviously it is receipt. Okay, and if the money is being spent by the central government, then it is expenditure. Okay, it is not very difficult to identify revenue receipt and revenue expenditure, and the reason is also very clear. We will discuss in later slides. Okay, so how will you remember capital receipts definition? I have used a very simple word, that is clear. Okay, let's say clear. Okay, you just memorize it in such a way that clear receipts, as far as capital receipt is concerned, you just remember clear receipts. Now let's see what is the full form of clear. Here this E in the clear, this E has no meaning at all, that's why I have given cross arrows, cross mark here. Okay, now C stands for create, L stands for liabilities, A stands for assets, and R stands for reduction. If you remember the word clear receipts, then clear, C, create liability or asset reduction. Such type of receipt of the government which will either create liabilities or reduce assets. If you go back to the definition, you will find the same thing. So if you remember the word clear, then you can easily write the definition of capital receipt and you can easily classify the capital receipt. Okay, so create liabilities, C means create, L means liabilities, E has no meaning. Just to make it easier to grasp the concept, I have used the word clear and E has no meaning here, but A assets and R reduction. So if you can remember the word clear, we keep on hearing the word clear everywhere, isn't it? So clear receipts. On the other hand, in case of capital expenditure, you remember the word relax. Okay, once you spend money, you are relaxed. Okay, when you are spending your money, be relaxed and spend your money. Okay, in the similar way, government is being relaxed and spending its money. But we need to replace this X with the alphabet C. Okay, so what happens here is relax. If you replace the word X, alphabet X by C, then you will find that RE is reduced, L liabilities, A assets, and X has been replaced by C, so creation. Relax means reduce liabilities and create assets. So if you write reduction of liability and asset creation, such type of expenditure of government which will reduce liabilities and create asset will be treated as capital expenditures. Okay, so this will help you out to remember or to memorize the definition of this capital receipts and capital, because often I have seen that you get confused between these two, capital receipts and capital expenditure. You write this for capital receipt and this for capital expenditure. The opposite answer is being written. So in order to get a clear concept about it, okay, what you have to remember is, in case of receipts, you have to remember the word clear receipts. Okay, in case of capital receipts, it will be clear receipts, and in case of expenditure, it will be relax. Expenditure and relax. Spend the money and relax. If you can remember this, then it will be very easier for you to classify or to identify whether a particular expenditure is a capital expenditure or revenue expenditure, and whether a particular receipt is a capital receipt or revenue receipt. So let us try to solve some of the questions which are very popular questions. This type of questions often comes in your board exam. Identify the following as revenue receipts and capital receipts. Give reasons. Okay, so let's see. First, corporation tax. Now, obviously in question itself, you have been given that you have to classify between, identify it as whether it is revenue receipt or capital receipt. So you don't have to think whether it is expenditure or not. Obviously, the money is coming to the government. Now, think that whether this earnings of government is creating any asset or liability or not, whether it is affecting the liability and asset of the government or not. Okay, so obviously we have seen that in components of budget, the tax revenue is the part of revenue receipt. So obviously this is revenue receipt, and revenue receipt neither creates, why it is revenue receipt, it will not neither create any liabilities nor reduce any asset of the government. It is not going to create any liability. Clear, remember that clear. So create liability, asset reduction. It is not going to either reduce asset or create liability. So obviously it is a part of revenue receipt. Okay. Next, loans recovered from public sector enterprises. Okay, the loans which the government has given to the public sector enterprises is now being recovered. Means the loan is coming back to the government. The principal amount is coming back to the government. We have discussed that principal amount is a part of capital budget. Obviously, this is capital receipt because money is coming to the government. But what will be the answer? Whether it is creating liability or reducing asset, you have to think, because receipt means clear receipt. Isn't it clear? Capital receipt means clear receipt. So you have to think whether in this case the asset part is being affected or the liability part is being affected. Obviously, loan is treated as an asset. As far as government has given the loan, central government has given the loan, then it is an asset because the government is going to get back the money very soon or maybe in a certain period of time. So obviously it is an asset. So here what is happening is asset has been reduced. Okay, now let us take third example. Dividend received by government from a company. At the public sector enterprise, government is getting dividend from the public sector enterprise. So obviously dividend is a part of non-tax revenue, which we have discussed earlier in our previous class. So dividend is neither affecting asset or liability. So obviously it is revenue receipts. So it is not creating any liability. Okay, it is not creating any liability, neither creating any liability nor reducing any asset. So it is part of the revenue receipt. Okay, on the other hand, amount borrowed from Japan for construction of metro. Now the government is borrowing money from the Japanese government. Okay, all Japanese industries. So what happens here is government is borrowing money. Okay, borrowing means liabilities. Liability will be created. So it is obviously part of capital receipts. Government is receiving money, but it is a liability because the government will have to be paid back. And we are dealing with the principal amount, not the interest amount. So it is a part of capital budget, capital receipts. Similarly, we're going to get the questions related to revenue expenditure and capital expenditures. Okay, identify the following as revenue expenditures and capital expenditures, giving reasons. Okay, so let us deal with it. Salary paid to army officers. Since salary of army officers are paid regularly, that means every month. Okay, and since it is not going to create asset or reduce liability of the government, obviously it is a part of revenue expenditure. So this revenue expenditure, as it neither creates any assets nor reduces any liabilities of the government. Okay, let us take another question. Repayment of loans. Okay, repayment of loans by whom? By the central government. The central government has taken loan. Maybe in previous example, in previous slide, we have discussed that government is getting loan from Japan to construct metro in India, isn't it? So let's say now the government is repaying it back to Japan. Okay, so repayment of loans. Obviously, repayment of loans, now relate it with that formula, RELAT. Okay, reduce liability, asset creation. Now when you repay back the loan, are you creating asset? No, isn't it? So what you are going to do? You are reducing liability, isn't it? The liability, the burden which was there with the government because it had to repay it someday. So now the government has repaid the loan. So obviously that is reducing the liabilities, RELAT. So reduce liability, asset creation is not here. So obviously this is capital expenditure and it reduces liabilities of the government. Again, liability has been reduced. So it is a part of capital expenditure. Now, again, let us take another. Interest paid on national debt. Now, time and again, I have been focusing or I have been emphasizing on this word, interest and principal. Interest and principal. Interest is a part of revenue budget. If government is getting interest, receipt is there, it is part of revenue receipt. If government is paying interest, then it is part of revenue expenditure. So interest paid on national debt. National debt means borrowings from the public. So when government borrowed from the public and now it is repaying only the interest amount of the debt. So it is obviously revenue expenditure. Okay, it is revenue expenditure and it is not going to affect any asset or liability of the government because it is just the interest part, not the principal part. Once the principal amount is repaid, it is obviously going to reduce liability, like in this case. But repayment of interest is not going to reduce the liability, nor it is going to create assets. So it is a part of the revenue expenditure of the government. Here you can also write the reason as it is recurring in nature. You can write that, but it is more suitable reasoning for this. And if you are not able to give reason, see, in boards, let's say three statements have come of this type, okay, and you have to identify whether it is, or let's say four questions have come, just like in this example, four questions have come, let's say like this, and it is of 6 marks. It means that one question carries 1.5 marks, isn't it? One subpart carries 1.5 marks. But if you are able to identify it, okay, like say this is revenue expenditure, this is capital expenditure, this is revenue expenditure, and in this case also you have written something, okay, you have written either revenue expenditure or capital expenditure, and let's say all your identification is correct but your reasoning is wrong, then you will not get any marks at all. You will get 0 marks. Okay, you may think that my identification was correct, I should be getting some marks, at least 0.5 marks on each subpart, I should be getting 2 marks. But if the CBSC, if you see the previous answer keys, okay, or the answer key of previous years of CBSC, by going to the CBSE website. If you download it, then you will clearly see the instruction that whoever has written the whoever has identified it correctly but not given the reason properly, they will not be rewarded any marks at all. Okay, so you have to be very careful when you are answering this type of question. You may identify it easily, but reasoning may get wrong. Okay, so you have to focus on the reasoning also. Okay, so expenditure on construction of bridge. Bridge obviously is an asset for the government. So here, what is happening? Asset is being created and government is spending the money. So obviously, it is capital expenditure because asset is being created. Now, it has nothing to do with liability, so we will not write that part. It is going to create asset and again, go back to that formula. Relax. Reduce liability, asset creation. You just check here whether asset is being created or liability is being reduced. You just check if asset is being created, then obviously it is capital expenditure, or else if liability is being reduced, it is also capital expenditure. In question number 2, liability was being reduced, so it was capital expenditure. In this case, it is different. Asset is being created, so it is an example of capital expenditure. Hope you have understood this section of which I have taught today. Okay, obviously we will meet again with my next lecture, which will be on budgetary deficit, which is the last section of this chapter, but we will further need 2 lectures to complete this unit or this chapter, because once I complete the budgetary deficit part, then we'll go to few exercises related to it, which may come in your board exams. Okay, so till then, thank you very much. Stay safe, stay at home, and then keep studying. Thank you. Thank you very much.